All right, ladies and gentlemen, okay, welcome to the stream. Feeling a little bit perkier today. Mostly because the missus was awesome today and went out to a place that we haven't had food from in quite some time. It does this killer chicken quesadilla. Oh, Jesus, it's so good. So I am pretty damn happy with that. I ate that. I haven't actually eaten in 24 hours, so the last thing I ate was a sandwich like yesterday morning. So I was a little hungry. Yeah, it's a bit difficult after you like get unplugged from the chemo stuff. That's actually the worst part because you lose your appetite in a really big way. But you've got to try and eat anyway because it makes the recovery a lot harder, and dehydration is obviously a big factor. But let's see, static on the mic. It's possible it'll probably clear up in about a minute. If it's the long-standing bug. I have reported this bug so many times. It is infuriating. There's nothing I can do about it. We're not the only ones to get it either. I think pretty much like anyone with an ACO interface that runs at this kind of bitrate has the same problem, which is infuriating. Okay, right. Let's get right in on this then, shall we? Everything seems to be running the way it's supposed to be, so let's get Grey Goo San on. Do let me know if the levels are incorrect, because obviously we're doing a little bit of guesswork on that, as we always do, because XSplit is a horrible liar. There we go. Cool. So this should get us into the main screen here. So as per the embargo, we're not going to be looking at the campaign. What we can do is we can have a look at multiplayer and skirmish. So I'll try and show you all three factions and give you an idea of what Grey Goo is actually all about. WTF is will be coming of this game, but I'm going to stick with the specific review embargo is the 23rd for this. Technically, I could probably get around it by just showing skirmish footage on the channel, but I don't know. I like to play fair, you know? So my video will go out the same time as everyone else's. Simple as that. But I am allowed to stream, so I'm going to do just that. Alright, we're going to do single player skirmish. It is actually called Grey Goo, yes. It's a bit of a weird title. It is an end of the world scenario, essentially, where nanobots eat everything. Like, it's actually a pretty well-known sci-fi apocalyptic scenario. But it is a little bit of a weird name for it anyway, right? It's a little bit strange. So I don't know, we'll just have to get over that. All right, let's jump into skirmish. So there's three factions available in the game, and it's actually not a huge number of skirmish maps initially. The game's designed around 1-on-1 and 2v2, but it does have custom maps, and you can make maps. So, you know, if the map pool is not large enough, they will be able to develop new maps. We'll run on something nice and simple like Coastlands, maybe, or Lost Plains. Both of these are reasonably good. We can go with either of those. Don't like Grotto Assault. That is Scrap Station. Fuck that. I'm not playing Scrap Station. That is air play. Like, I'd go straight air and attack from there if I was playing that map immediately. We'll go with Coastlands. So you've got several game modes. So your standard mode is destroy all HQ, refineries, and production buildings. Annihilation is blow up everything, and destroy HQ is just destroy HQ. You've got your free-for-all 1v1 and 2v2 options, and you can turn epic units on or off. Each faction, of which there are three, has an epic unit. It's very, very hard to build. It's extremely destructive if you manage to put it together. So, there we go. Alright, let's roll with Coastlands then. So, we've got three factions. You've got the humans, the betas, and the goo. The humans are, you'd expect them maybe to be the lowest tech faction. They're actually not. They're the highest tech faction. The betas are a alien race. They're probably the most traditional of the three factions. They're certainly, I'd say, a great deal more sensible than the other ones when it comes to design. The others have some interesting ideas behind them. And the goo, well, the goo is the goo. There's not a lot to say about the goo other than that it's the goo, and we're probably going to start by playing the goo. The goo is the hardest faction in the game to play, at least in my honest opinion, because the way they don't have a base. So the way that they gather resources requires quite a lot of micro. If you want to play a faction that doesn't require a lot of micro, the other two are much, much better than that. We will go against the betas, I think. There we go. That seems reasonable. And it gives you, in the skirmish mode, like a few different generals that you can pick from. So you can have, hey, balanced military, favors economic power, favors military power, favors strong defense. We'll go with strong defense, because that might let me build a bunch of stuff, because if Cassini's going to turtle, then that'll make things a little bit easier. So we'll start with the goo, and we'll see what comes of the goo, shall we? And we'll have epic units on, because that allows us to build the biggest goo, which is the best goo, of course. All right, let's get in. Let's get in. So the humans and the betas are relatively similar. They use their base building mechanics are not entirely identical, but they are similar enough in the way that they act. The goo doesn't work like that at all. The goo is a little bit weird. So let's begin. This is your base. It's goo. It's also a unit. So it can go wherever it pleases because it is goo. It can go over mountains. So with the goo, what you have to do is you've got to gather resources. And usually, like any of the other two factions, they'd find these resource pools here that are called catalyst pools. And what they'd do is they'd build an extractor and they'd start mining from them. Goo doesn't work that way. The goo moves over a piece of catalyst and it collects resources from it when it does it. And the ideal thing you want to do with the goo is to try and move them between catalyst pools as quickly as possible, because these things rapidly regenerate, so you can pick up more and more and more resources. Now, once you've got enough resources, you can split your goo off into smaller goos. So you can morph it into a small protein, a large protein, a mother goo, which is one of these, or you can use part of the size of your goo to do a research upgrade, which will allow you to upgrade one of your existing buildings. And then if you reach maximum goo size, you can start morphing the proto purger, which is the biggest unit in the game and eats fucking everything and is evil. It also started me off with a drover, which is a little scout unit here as well. So I'm moving this goo around to increase the size of it. You'll notice this little bar here increases every time I go over one of these pools, and this will allow me to get larger and then spawn a small protein, which I will do. Now, off in the corner, the betas are probably just doing the same thing. They're building a base. You don't build a base as the goo, you are the base. So your base is going to be constantly moving around, and you're going to have multiple bases as well. Now, the goo can fight, and it's pretty good at it as well, assuming that your opponent isn't very good at micromanagement. It can eat pretty much anything it comes across. So now I've got enough resources to make a small protein. I could keep going if I wanted. I could get, if I got another set of that, I could build a large protein, but we'll go with a small protein. So there we go. The goo splits off and this is now a unit. This unit can either fight or it can become one of four different sets of units. So this might remind you actually a little bit of the way that, what was the name of that game? What was it? Perimeter worked. Yeah, Perimeter kind of did this kind of same thing. So there's quite a lot of micro involved in this. You can actually like set up a patrol path here. Oh, there's an enemy unit. I'm gonna chase that down. Little guy's got a shotgun for a face, so why not? If you rush with the goo, they'll probably die. Like, the goo doesn't kill buildings that quickly, so it's a surefire way to die, and the goo doesn't move very fast either. So I can fight with this, or I can make it into stuff. So I can make four drovers with this, and it immediately morphs. It's actually kind of cool, because you could go into a fight. Oh, we're gonna see if we can eat this. Watch what the goo does here. Get back here. Ah, the AI is microing against it, but I've caught him. So the goo will actually eat anything it comes across, assuming it's able to get in touch with it. But of course, like, the AI is going to micro to make sure that I can't actually touch it. So, I'll send my drovers in and they'll be able to kill it. Just try and micro this guy back so he doesn't die. There we go. Okay, so that's that scout unit nice and easily killed. Cool. Alright, so I've got a couple of little drover units. They're not particularly powerful, but they're pretty good at harass, so I might want to send them up there and see if I can kill a harvester or two. In the meantime, we can try and continue these upgrades. What I want to do is maybe get a second goo, because that'll allow us to send it over the other side of the map and start mining resources from there. So I'm going to morph a second mother goo, and there we go. And that goo can look, there's three resource pools here that it could very easily micro between. There we go, so we'll set up a quick patrol route. So it's going to bounce between them, and it's going to hopefully eat a bunch of stuff. Now, if you're not into the micromanagement, what you can do is you can build a lot of mother goos, and you can just leave them on these little pads, because they regenerate the what they're called resource spigots every couple of seconds. So you can do that, but it's more efficient to do what I'm doing right now. So I've sent my my guys in against them right now, which is going to, it'll do the job. I mean, these are the cheapest units in the game, so I can do that. So I've killed that unit, and now I can maybe go and try and harass their miners over here. There we go. Cool. Let's make a little small protein. Should do the job. Alright. The cool thing is, you could actually go into a fight with the small protein, then immediately morph it into the units that you think you might need. So if you don't know what you're up against, you can move around with these as a unit, and then you can instantly morph them into stuff. So if they have aircraft, you could morph them into anti-aircraft stuff and things like that. So you kind of get the idea. So I have my little protein around here, which moves a lot faster, and it can also climb over any terrain, which is pretty neat. So what I want to be doing is building probably a few of these, and then I might want to be thinking, well, you know, what kind of resources do I want? What kind of stuff do I want to upgrade? So I'll be looking at like the upgrade tech, and I'll be seeing, look, is there a unit here that might be useful? So what do I want to build? Like, I've got all of these resource credits that I can use. So I could, if I want to build a bunch of destructors, I could do that. That's got a goose splash upgrade. Or there's also a bounce upgrade. Let's get that. Okay, so that's going to take a few minutes, certainly, to come up with. All right, my guys are going to get cleaned up now, but they've done a decent amount of damage, so I'm not really too worried about that. There we go. We're still just sort of microing around this area at the moment just to gather more stuff. So what I want to do is try and get a large protein, which is going to let me build a destructor. And I'm also getting that upgrade for the destructor as well. These guys are pretty good. They'll do their job, but they're not particularly powerful. We should be able to catch them, actually. There we go. We managed to chase them down with the protein. That's a cool thing. These builders are actually fighting units as well. There's nothing stopping you from attacking with them. Although, if you lose them, then that's very, very... Apparently my... Well, yeah, the for the goo, all of the noise is very distorted deliberately, so... for the other units, they're not. So, yeah, you will find that there's... It's just because I think they wanted to, like, represent nanobots or something, so they had this kind of weird idea about how things would sound. But yeah, they are supposed to sound that way. That is not unusual. Okay, we've got a couple of units here that we might want to try and kill if possible. If I might be able to trap them, actually, between the two, and I'd be able to suck them up that way. Although, as you can see, the small proteins die really fast, so you might want to be a little bit careful about using them as combat units. They are good for chasing small units down, though, and then you can just eat them up. So we're looking to get a large protein. And then we can start building some destructors. Alright, I'm gonna grab a couple of Tempests. There we go. So these are nice little handy units. They're anti-air artillery pieces. Okay, and he can make a large protein as well, which is great. Cool. There we go. Just make sure the patrol is working the way it's supposed to be. Okay, so now my large protein can build a whole bunch of stuff. And we're gonna build two destructors, which are tanks. There we go. And what I then want to try and do is maybe try and find an expansion of his. He probably has one somewhere. So this is I probably want to escort this with a bunch of smaller units as well. Just eat that. There we go. The only thing I kind of find annoying is like the patrol micro required here is a little bit fiddly. I don't know if there's a way to automate it. There might be. But I'm not 100% sure at this point. Alright, let's morph another small protein in. In fact, let's morph in two small proteins. Three small proteins. There we go. So we can... The thing about the goo is if you can actually build up a very, very large mother goo, then you can build a whole bunch of units really fast. So I can morph this into 16 units right here if I wanted to. I'm gonna go for some striders, though. So we're gonna morph in 8 striders. And you basically make an instant army, which is really scary. Okay, let's see what the destructor research is looking like. And yeah, we'll have that in 5 seconds. So we're about ready to attack. And it looks like they're trying to mine from here. So we're going to blow that up. There we go. So yeah, that's the scary thing about the goo. You do have to micro a bit more to get resources at the optimal rate. But you can morph into almost anything very rapidly. So you're like a very reactive army. All right. Let's see what we can come up with. Yeah, we've got enough units, I think, to do some pretty damn serious damage. Our destructors also have a bounce ability now because we upgraded them with that, so we should be able to do some good damage here. Let's morph in some more protein. Let's get a larger protein here as well. And we can actually just, like, send this all the way up there, morphing into something else. There we go. I think this AI is probably about to get wrecked, actually. If we blow up this medium hub, then we'll be able to take down a lot of our ability to build. There we go. Cool. And if we kill a HQ, then of course they're going to be in a lot of trouble. I think we're actually about to win this. The economic AI is apparently not that amazing. Send the smaller goo over here. The large goo is on its way. And we can morph that into a couple more destructors. Or some bastions, which are... They're actually like line-of-sight blocker taunting units. There's then artillery pieces. We can let's get a couple of crescents just to show you what they do. So these are artillery pieces here that they swing... Very, very slow arcing goo projectiles, but they can also sit on hills, which makes them pretty damn devastating. I'm gonna grab a couple of radiants to give me some more line of sight here. The combat music depends on. We're gonna play another faction next, which has a lot of more traditional combat music in it, which is kind of neat because Frank Lopaki actually did the work on this. so some of this stuff sounds really, really good. The Goo's probably got, like, the weakest soundtrack, I think. But the other two raises have some incredible music. There we go, let's do that. We can grab that and send some more goo over here. There we go. So unless he's expanded all over the place, I think we've got this pretty much locked down. Let's continue to goo up everything we possibly can. There we go. And send these smaller units over here. Everything that comes out of here is just getting absolutely destroyed. I got wrecked the last time playing against the military AI, but the economic AI seems to be fairly easy. From what I can tell. I'm gonna go just morph these into the drovers. They're gonna do a pretty good job of murdering things at close range. That's what they do. If I want to, showing the big goo unit would take a little bit of work. It's not impossible. I would need to get maximum goo size and then morph some other goos into that goo. But I've got to be careful. You've got to have at least one mother goo alive, I think, at any given time. Otherwise, you're in big trouble. I think this guy's almost at the right size where he could start to morph into the Purger, which is the big unit. So we will try and do that. I just want to goo up this base so that they can't do anything. Which it looks like we're pretty much done. They're not going to be able to do much, so I'm just going to back off now. Oh, the game also has brush, kind of like League of Legends, by the way. If you move any units into the forest, they do become invisible unless you've got scout aircraft to look for them. So you can it's actually kind of a nerf to bomber aircraft, because you can't precisely target anything that's in the jungle. You've got to get a scout on it. Okay, we're almost at the right size here. I say that some people are going to find this level of micro a little bit annoying. You don't have to do that. If you get a lot of mother goose, say like you get 4 or 5, you can literally just leave them on a resource spot and they will grow. They're just not going to grow as fast as if you micro them in this way, if you bounce them between resource points. Okay. Gooing up everything here. Alright. Almost at maximum size, I think, for these. So we should be able to build the proto-purger, which takes forever. Okay. I thought we were able to build it there. I think we need to be... Oh yeah, we need to be sitting on a resource point to build it. There we go. So that's going to start building the proto-purger. Here I'm going to build another mother goo, and I'm going to send that over to merge with it. That's going to increase the building time of the proto-purger. And then what we'll do is we'll set the proto-purger on the enemy base, and you can have a laugh at what it does, because it's really insane. There we go, we'll spawn another mother goo here, because we can. And I'm going to actually send this over to mine from here. But yeah, if you're more of like micro-intensive, then I think this race is pretty good. It's also like highly mobile. It doesn't have to be in a fixed location. You can move it around. So that's pretty cool. Alright, there we go. So we're going to morph this goo into the Purger, which is about halfway built. Just gotta watch out because this thing can't actually fight, so if you run into problems with this guy, you're gonna have a lot of trouble. And it's very, very expensive. Each race has one. The humans have the Alpha, which I think is a giant kind of mech robot thing, and the, if I recall correctly, the Betas have the Hand of Rack, which is a large sort of mobile garrison. The UI changes depending on what race you're in. What I will say is there is some kind of nice functionality with the UI that isn't really as obvious with the goo, in that they actually break everything down by QWER combinations, which is actually very familiar if you played something like Dota. So if I hit Q, it's going to say, oh, here's your buildings, and then you can hit Q again. So you've actually got a series of very quick hotkeys that can be used in order to build buildings very rapidly. It just doesn't work quite as well with the goo because you need proteins out on the field to build anything. Now, if you do this with any of the other races, you can actually rapidly learn hotkeys that will let you build stuff without going back to your base really quickly. So it's a lot less complicated than StarCraft from the economic standpoint. It's actually a really nice set of hotkeys. I like it a lot. Like, if you played, like, Smite or Tribes and you learned any of the key combinations to put out information, then it's actually a very intuitive interface. The problem is, like, as I said, it doesn't work quite as well with the goo because of the way that the goo splits off and doesn't, like, have any big factories. Like, if with the humans and the Betas, you have permanent factories which are constantly pumping out units. With the goo, you only get units when you build stuff. so it gets a little bit weird. Speaking of it weird, I don't think I actually have any anti-air, so this could be a bit of a problem. I might want to build some of that. Let's, this goo should have enough to build a couple of small proteins so I can build some tempests. That should do the job. There we go. And then if I want to build anything, I just hit... Because I have these now on the field. So I want to build light units. I hit Q. I want to build tempests. I hit R twice. There we go. Easy peasy. Really quick when you get used to it. I think like it's going to be a pretty neat RTS for those who are perhaps struggling with a lot of the stuff that you have to do with a more complicated RTS like StarCraft. Because the macro is a lot easier to handle. How close can you zoom? Quite close. A lot of detail on this map, actually. Really nice detail, as you can see. The goo actually is dynamically morphs depending on its terrain, which I find to be particularly neat. When I played in the alpha, this used to tank the frame rate. Doesn't anymore, thankfully. Okay, cool. We now have our anti-air stuff out, which is nice. The upgrade system is kind of interesting. They don't have... they've got no... activatable abilities for any unit, which I'm not massively keen on, but what they do have is the upgrades make huge differences to the way that units operate. Basically, there's no such thing as an obsolete unit in this game. At least that's the idea anyway. What they're basically saying is, look, every unit should be useful at any part of the game as long as you've upgraded it to actually fulfill a role. I'm gonna morph in two more Mother Goose so that we can send them over there to increase the speed of the Purger building. So they're gonna slither on over there. So that, you know, that's the hope of it anyway, that even your most basic units will be useful. I don't think the Drover has an upgrade as far as I know, and which is a bit weird, but as a result, you can build a lot of those really fast, so they're really nice harassment units. Also, once you've built an upgrade, I'm pretty sure it, like, blocks out any other upgrades that you can get, so you've got to make some kind of permanent tech choices throughout the game, if I recall correctly. Yeah, you see here? Like, once I've picked an upgrade from this, now I can't pick any other upgrades from here. So every time you play a game, you're going to be picking a perhaps different tech paths, depending on what you're doing. So that I find to be a fairly interesting thing. Okay, the purge is almost ready. This is going to be fun. Almost done. It's at 4,000 HP out of 5,000. Then we can unleash it and see what happens. And that's going to be interesting, to say the least. Yeah, UI size. I don't think you can change that. Let me have a quick look. They don't have a huge amount of UI customization, which I think is something they need to work on. You can do things like group move at slowest unit speed, and you can change when they display health bars. But outside of that, the UI is a bit big. I will agree with that. This is actually a thing that they've had problems with for a while. They've been doing... Yeah, we're maximum there? Yeah, we are. Okay, cool. And this is all Frank Lepaki music, so screw it. We're just gonna... Fuck it, we're adding all. Here we go. Track shuffle is on. I wanna hear some... It's 1 hour 48. Sweet. I'm happy to hear that. Let's put that on the jukebox. There we go. Cool. 1 hour 48 of new Frank Lepaki. Absolutely. That's what I'm talking about. There we go. It's almost done. It's getting there. But yeah, I'd say the UI is a little bit big. It's something that Petroglyph has had problems with in all their games. Like, even things like Empire at War, the UI was too big there. The UI was too big in Universe at War. The AI was too big at End of Nations. They like their big UIs, and I don't think they're they don't need to be as large as they are. They take up a lot of space that really isn't necessary. It's like, oh no, there's a unit. Eat it. There we go. Om nom 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 nom. Lovely. All right, the Purger should almost be ready. Come on, I want to play with the Purger. I should send over another Mother Goo to accelerate. Once this thing's out on the field, stopping it is now impossible. It's just an absolute beast. But yeah, we're pretty much starved out the enemy at this point. Nothing to really worry about. Let's get that morphed in there. I'd say the UI is a bit bigger than StarCraft. I think, again, as someone pointed out in chat, there's a lot of border which doesn't need to be there. I think that's got a lot to do with it. Okay, 700. Almost there. Then once I've finished with this, I'll show you the other factions, which are a little bit more traditional. Do it again, a little bit more patrolling here. Again, I wish there was a way to repeat this, but I imagine that's part of the micro that is required to most efficiently use this race. All Right, we are about done. Just need one more. And then we'll send the purger in, and then things will start to get amusing. In fact, screw it. I'm gonna feed it the last goo. I don't even know if it'll get there before the build actually finishes. It takes ages to build the epic units, which is not that surprising. Yeah, basically it takes, you spend parts of the goo which shrinks the goo, and then you need to collect resources to rebuild the size of the goo in order to get more units. That's the way the goo works. Alright, proto-purge is about ready. This should be fun. Alright, here we are. Welcome to the purger! Let's go and have some fun with it. So this is the epic unit for the goo race. And it does some very amusing things. It is not a pleasant little beastie, not at all. Absolutely not. It is not the life of the party. Can I increase game speed? I don't think so. Let me have a look at hotkeys and see if there's a way to do that. Interface. You have a lot of binding options here, which is good. I think the game speed is just what it is. I don't think there's a way to increase it. I might be wrong, though. Yeah, doesn't seem like it. This is the speed the game runs. Alright, let's send the Proto-Purger in and see what it does. I imagine it is not a very friendly beast. Okay, well, let's attack that. Yeah, that's what it does. It's not a pleasant thing. Not at all. It covers things in tentacles and eats them. It is a land kraken, essentially. There we go. It is a bit of a beast. I'm going to send it in nice and close and then send the rest of my army in to finish these guys off. So it's got a massive AoE. It can hit all of these buildings and just absolutely decimate them. There we go. Not a pleasant creature. And that should be game, I think. Unless they've managed to... Yeah, that's its right click. That's what it does when you right click something. It murders things in a large AoE, which is devastating because... A lot of the ways that both the other factions make buildings which link together, so any kind of area of effect attack is really dangerous. So an epic unit being able to demolish a base like that is terrifying. It's a giant sunken colony, essentially. Alright, and that should be game. There we go. Alright, let's show you the other two. Because they do work a little bit differently. They're a little bit... If you're not comfortable with the micro, then I wouldn't play goo, because particularly in the early game, you've really got to move your goo around a lot and make sure that you collect the right amount of resources. And if you don't do that at the right speed and keep with everything else, it becomes a very difficult game to play. All right, let's play that terrible map, like that's clearly Scrap Station. Just give me one moment here. Gonna quickly check a few things out. All right. Cool. All right, let's have a quick leap into the next one. We'll do humans now, I guess. Where's my screen gone? There it is. Cool. Esports potential. It's the lack of micro that I think will probably bust it in that regard. I think that it'll certainly be a fun kind of casual game to play. 2v2 might be pretty good. The problem I have with it is that there's really not a lot of micro involved, because they took out pretty much any ability that requires micromanagement. So you can pull units back, but that's kind of the extent of the micro. And you can micro in between forests and outside of forests, because that'll break line of sight. But it's, like, compared to StarCraft 2, which has a lot of intricacy and a lot of control, this game doesn't have that, which for a lot of people is going to be fine. Like, I don't think that you should judge a game based on its esports potential, because I don't think that's necessarily that important. What's important is the ability to get a lot of people into the game and actually get a solid multiplayer community going, which you can absolutely do. You can absolutely do that, but you don't need to have a huge esports scene to make that happen. It's a more traditional RTS. It's definitely more casual friendly. It's easier to get into, because the level of micro and the level of macro required are much less than current games. So, alright, cool. So this is your core. Now, I can actually show this off properly now. You see what I'm doing here? With the Q and the W and everything? This is a really nice, quick way to actually select buildings and build stuff really fast. So with the human faction, you start with a core, and everything kind of builds out from there. And it actually comes in from the sky, which is really neat to watch. And you've got to connect things up with power lines in order to make things happen. And the thing is, with those power lines, you can also teleport buildings to different places along the power line. So you can move turrets and things, if you want. That's some very Frank Lopaki stuff going on in the background there. That's what we like to hear. Alright, cool. So we got that. We can add a silo on here. And everything kind of comes together like a jigsaw puzzle. So we want probably a factory here. We'll want a little bit of space to make sure that we can put some add-ons on. There we go. Now, in terms of resources, you'll notice that it actually uses the total annihilation system, sort of. So everything will stop when you run out of resources, but you can build stuff before you have the necessary resources to build it. You can actually start it off. I'd say it's very, very accessible, actually. It doesn't have a particularly high learning curve, at least with these two factions. I think you could maybe make the argument that the Goo faction has a higher learning curve, but it's still pretty good. Alright. Okay, so I'm building a silo there. The silo's also going to unlock some upgrades for me. As you can see, almost every building has an upgrade of some description I can get. So I could actually give my harvester stealth, which seems OP as shit. I can make invisible harvesters. Or I could get sentinel structures all repair over time while not suffering damage, or extractors gain additional armor repair over time. These are all mutually exclusive. Alright, so now, if I hit W, I can then hit either Q or W to build either a trident or revolver. So, we can start building some revolvers, I think. You can loop buildings as well, by the way. If you wanted to build nothing but revolvers till the end of time, you can do that. Alright, now, outside of that, we want to put an add-on onto this thing. So, I want it to be able to build more units, so I want to build, say, let's put a tank add-on on there. And considering what we're up against, we'll probably want to build an air add-on as well. There we go. Now what else can we do? Well, we can build turrets, we can build walls. So we know where did the enemy come from. Kind of across this direction, we could build a wall if we liked. We'll probably want to think about expanding though, so I'll need to save up some money in order to actually make that happen. Now if I turn on this, that should show me where the next resource pool is, which is over there. Now if I recall correctly, I think I have to build a conduit now, which will let me get over there. So if I do it... This faction I'm, like, the least experienced with, so you're gonna have to forgive me if I mess things up here. Unit ready. Unit in production. Alright, cool. Tank attachment complete. So now we have a tank attachment, which lets me build air Gladius, and we now have an air attachment, which lets me build a monitor. But if I want to build something more advanced than that, I need something else. So, with a tank and air attachment, I could build something different. And the more of these attachments you have, the more advanced units you unlock. Unit ready. It's really kind of that simple. So this is the tech that I currently have, air tech and tank tech. So if I want to build some more tech, I could do that. Let's see if we can get... We're going to need to build this conduit over here, I think, if we want to actually build another refinery, which is going to be very expensive, but we're going to need to expand. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to make enough money. Group in motion. Right. Let's complete. Rock and roll. Conduit complete. Okay, conduits are now building in. As you can see, they're going to power things up. And don't kill him. There we go. The reason the music is as it is because I put it on shuffle mode. So if you want the music to come in at the right time, like combat music and building music, you can do that. But I put it on shuffle mode because I wanted to hear all the music. It's that simple. Understood. Forming there now. Group in motion. Support ready. Revolver ready. So that is the reason why the music is the way that it is. Alright, let's see if they've expanded. Might have taken expansion down here. Might be able to ambush them. Unit under attack. Alright, take a bit of damage here. Let's try and pull our revolver back. There we go. Cool. Nice easy win. That's about the extent of a lot of the micro that you can do. It's not really that crazy. We're still trying to finish this refinery up. Oh! Oh god, what the hell is that? Oh, it's an avalanche. It's an artillery piece. And it is killing me horribly. If I get... Oh, and getting nice and close doesn't work. Right, okay. They have a really scary thing. I probably need air units. Scimitar air bomber would probably be good here. What do I need? We need an air pad in order to get that up. So I'm going to build an air pad, and then I can try and build some bombers to handle that. All right, cool. We have another refinery out. So I've got a little bit of... We actually have a little bit extra resources to work with here. I think I've ended up with one of the military guys, so this is going to be a lot harder.
Air pad complete.
Sweet. Let's build a scimitar bomber. And I think I'm not sure how many air pads you need but you probably need quite a few. The air, it works in a similar way to the way that Red Alert 2 did with its aircraft. Also generals, where they'll fight and then they'll have to rearm. So the bombers are going to need probably more air pads. All right, let's look at research as well, because there's other things we can do. What about tech upgrades here? So maybe we can get some tech upgrades for the air. Scythe will have 8 ammo. Scimitar weapon becomes a mine that can be ground targeted. Air pads now repair all docked units over time. That seems really useful. Let's grab that.
Beginning air tech upgrade.
This is getting... Oh, Jesus Christ. I need that aircraft quickly. Otherwise, I'm going to die to this one unit. I currently can't stop it. It's this nasty little artillery piece. My extractor is getting absolutely destroyed.
Repairing.
All right, bombers up.
Unit ready.
Get over here.
Extractor under attack.
Okay, cool. Got it.
Flying out.
We're going to lose the extractor. Thankfully, we can rebuild that.
Extractor
all right.
Destroyed.
Cool. Sweet. Our bomber was able to take that out, thankfully. And it's now going to redock. Actually, looks like an ornithopter. You look at that? It's pretty neat.
Attack.
Like that. All right, we're going to need more air pads. And we've got plenty of cash, so we should be building more stuff. We can also build turrets, which we are currently not building for some reason. So let's get some anti-heavy sentinels out.
Refinery under
send
attack.
The bomber out again. And
unit in production.
Let's build some gladiators, because evidently our revolvers are not doing the job here at all. We'll probably need some more factories as well. So let's do that. Let's get a large factory out. This can build 3 units at a time. So this might be a lot more useful.
Conduit cross complete.
Yeah, this bomber's pretty effective.
Anti-heavy sentinel complete.
All right, now if I understand it, you can actually teleport these. So you can, if you're connected to a conduit, you can actually teleport turrets. So I can move
beginning
it here, and then teleport it back if I like, which is pretty neat. All right, let's reestablish
beginning
the refinery. Let's get some walls up and actually start to defend against these bastards.
Complete.
There we go. Let's put that back where it's supposed to be over
beginning
here.
Construction.
And
unit
we'll.
Ready.
This seems like a pretty vulnerable
unit
area, so
production.
I'm gonna. Build a wall here.
Anti-heavy sentinel complete.
There we go. Okay. Let's have a look at some more units. We need more air pads. Otherwise, we're not going to be getting anywhere here. So I can attach them onto here. Let's build 3 more air pads. What's the money looking like? We're getting a little bit short. Okay, we're going to watch out for that.
Scimitar ready.
I'm going to send the scimitar over and see if I can
confirm.
Hit something with it.
I'm going.
It's pretty fast.
Large factory complete.
Okay, cool. We have a much bigger
air pad
factory now.
Complete.
That's very useful.
Wall complete.
Moving.
Let's see if we can bomb that. Nice. Okay, so they've got an army coming our way, but we will be able to deal with it. Now, I'm going to need more attachments to this so that it can build stuff, so I probably want to try and get all 4 attachments if possible. For what I think that's attached to that because it's connected to a conduit, so that should be fine. We'll get the stealth attachment up as well, see if we can get some stealth units. So we have some tanks here now. And these walls, I think, are just force fields. I'm pretty sure I can just travel right through them. That's a nice little bit of detail there. Yeah, it's just ripples as you go through. I like that. So these walls are pretty good. We might want to extend the conduits out so that I can get my turrets closer to the walls.
Beginning construction. Unit ready. Beginning construction.
All right, can I build a few more scimitar bombers now?
Upgrade
yes,
complete.
I can. Good. Let's do that.
Unit in production.
All right, so we aren't least mining. We probably want to expand again, maybe out here.
Artillery attachment complete.
Nice. What can we build now with that?
Complete.
Okay. It's not connected, so that doesn't work the way that I'd hoped it would, unfortunately. I could still build some stuff with it if I want, but unless that it seems like unless they're directly attached to them, they just don't work. So we're just going to sell those. Just a little annoying.
Unit in production. I'm
actually aware of that. What have we got over here? Under attack. Gladius should be able to handle these, no problem. Now we can teleport this a bit closer.
Beginning construction.
There we go. Gladius took them out, no problem.
Anti-heavy sentinel complete.
How many more aircraft have we got? We are building quite a few.
Unit in
production. We have two scimitars out. Alright. Good. Let's keep doing that. One of the air pads are managing to do a good job of repairing things. I guess it must be... That's actually really annoying. The way that I built the factory in completely the wrong place, basically, so I can't put the add-ons on that I want. So... It's gonna spam stuff, I suppose. Let's just give it a tank attachment so it can spam gladiuses. Alright. Let's see if we can get some more mining going on. If I get my... Extend my conduits beginning out here, then maybe I can start to mine this area. Mining from here, that's good. Oh, hello.
Wall under attack.
Yeah, let's bomb the shit out of that thing.
Conduit cross complete. Conduit complete.
That should do the trick.
Taking the lead.
Come on. Alright, what kind of economic tech do I want to get? I want something that... I'd say the... That's a... All of these are really interesting. Like, I'd take pretty much any of them. Sentinel structures all repair over time while not suffering damage. I think it's probably the... Well, those are the turrets, so... Yeah, let's get the extractor one, because we keep getting harassed. Upgrade. So I don't want that to happen.
Information.
Alright, we've got three scimitar bombers. Let's see if we can do some damage with them. In the meantime, I'm stacking up a huge number of resources that I'm not using on anything, so... Let's build a bunch of gladiuses out of that production. Heavy factory. And we can
unit ready.
Just bomb that extractor. There we go.
Unit in production.
Cool. All right. Don't forget. Am I in reach from here?
Beginning construction.
Looks like it's out of range. It's okay. Can we teleport that? We probably can't, can we? No, I think. Let's see how. How close can I get to that? I think you actually have to go all the way round. I'm pretty sure you can't access it from here. So the best bet is actually to move our conduits further along here. I don't know if we can do that with the wall there, though.
Unit
oh, yes, you can.
Ready.
Okay, that's fine, then.
Unit in
all right, so we just build a bunch
unit
of...
Ready.
Nope, that's not working either. Okay. Interesting. I might want a few more air pads as well. We're going to commit...
Beginning construction.
To building a bunch of these things.
Combat routines restored. Blow through.
Alright, let's see if we can blow
taking
up the extractor.
Information. Sweeping in.
Airpad complete.
But yeah, the UI for the goo is excessive,
wall
I think.
Attack.
And whereas the UI for the humans
unit
is a lot
ready.
Easier to see. There you go, put a few
unit
bombs
ready.
On that thing. Hello, looks like
unit
we have some friends.
Wall under attack.
So it doesn't seem like you can get conduits through walls, which is maybe a bit of a problem.
Destroyed. Unit under attack.
I guess it's a good job that one of them just blew up, didn't it?
Pressing on.
Beginning construction.
So I think we'd actually have to sell the wall. So you have to be a bit careful about what you choose to do with your wall placement.
Conduit cross.
Now these are supposed to sell on Alt S, which doesn't actually seem to work. Not really. Oh. I don't know what the hell happened there. Did I sell it or did I blow it up? I don't know. Okay, it does work.
Unit ready.
Right, let's... Where's the nearest expansion? We're gonna have to go that way. Okay.
Beginning construction.
It looks like you can't expand too quickly. You've got to wait for the conduits to go up and then build the next one and so on and so forth. That, I suppose, makes a decent degree of sense.
Conduit
all right.
Cross complete.
And our bombers should be able to take the extractor out.
Conduit complete.
Cool. Need to learn these hotkeys as well. I think you need
Gladius
visibility.
Ready.
Looks like you might. Alright, let's build a few more scimitars because we've got three more air pads now. And we can keep building gladiuses. What I should actually do is just set this heavy factory to constantly build gladiuses on a loop.
Economic tech upgrade.
And we should also
complete.
Look for tech upgrade for
unit
those units.
Production.
So we already have the aircraft repair upgrade. Is there a gladius upgrade? Gladii, howitzers, all repair over time while not suffering damage. I'd say that's a pretty good upgrade. Let's do that.
Upgrade.
Cool. And that one is... So it's QQE, by the looks of it, in order to rapidly build a conduit. Okay. It's a bit annoying that the conduit's going at an angle. It would be nice if they went straight. I'm not really sure what's going on with that. Because it makes it a little bit fiddly to get around these areas. I'm not really sure what their logic behind that was.
Conduit cross.
I'm sure there's a reason. I just don't know what it is.
Conduit complete. Unit ready. Unit under attack.
Location.
I do kind of wish there was a more interesting upgrade for the Gladius.
Complete.
Some of the units have some really cool stuff, conduit and then it's like, complete. Oh, auto repair. Like, well, I mean, I guess that's okay. It's not. It's not really like. It's not like a upgrade
unit
that kind of completely changes
attack.
The face of the game, I guess.
Underground, moving, calculating route.
And these, the conduit stuff is fiddly, unnecessarily so.
Beginning construction.
I think they could do a better job with that.
Beginning construction.
Not too far away.
Location marked. Changing location.
Conduit cross complete.
We can do that. There we go.
Conduit complete.
And now we get some
unit ready.
Anti-heavy sentinels that
unit
we just connect to this.
Attack.
And that should defend that nice and easily.
Beginning construction.
Alright, cool. We should have a bunch of
unit
bombers
ready.
Now.
Refinery complete.
On alert. Complete. Send traffic.
Alright, let's go bomb the shit out of them.
Cap there. Online. Taking point. Blow through.
Don't know what that is, but I'm gonna blow
complete.
It up. To refinery.
Anti-heavy sentinel.
There we go. Did we lose one? No.
Unit ready. Unit in production.
Nice. I can build a conduit out here, and then
beginning
I can actually build just another refinery on the end there.
Barrels primed. Tank operational.
Let's go and see if they've expanded anywhere.
Conduit cross complete. Conduit complete.
The refinery down. Good, good.
Waiting for flight plan.
Something else that we can harass.
Information.
Unit under attack.
Oh, okay. They have anti-air. Shit. Might want to not run into that. Okay, so these are my five upgrades. So I can still get an artillery tech upgrade. I can still get a stealth tech
unit
upgrade.
Ready.
Ooh,
unit
I can build scythe heavy
production.
Air fighters now as well. Because I have all the right attachments for that. Which... Not sure if they're better or worse. I imagine they probably stay in the air a lot longer. So we can grab some of that. So we've upgraded from tank tech.
Capping in place.
We need stealth tech. So monitors gain stealth, daggers gain stealth, and all conduits generate proximity. That's hilarious. Okay, that I want. So let's get a stealth attachment so that I can deal. Let's actually build another large factory, hopefully in a place that actually
tank
makes
tech
sense.
Upgrade complete.
Maybe closer towards the front lines.
Unit ready.
There we go. This seems like a good place to build it.
Unit in production.
And then we can add stealth upgrades to that.
Beginning construction.
And we could actually, if possible, try and add all four and get the ultimate unit.
Beginning construction.
Not sure if that would work. It might.
Awaiting instruction. Combat systems enabled. Assemble right away.
Alright, so we've got that.
Unit
we need another
ready.
Refinery here.
Beginning
but
construction.
I am absolutely 110% getting the upgrade,
conduit
which makes conduits
complete.
Spawn invisible mines.
Unit ready.
That sounds great.
Bearings calibrated.
Refinery complete.
Alright, so I built one of those heavier air fighters. I'm not sure where
target.
It is and what it does.
Large factory complete.
At least I think
cap
I built
there.
One. Maybe it's not done yet.
Path.
Extractor complete.
Oh, here it is.
Online, heading out.
Okay, how does this... What does it actually do?
Right
Let's
away.
Find out.
En route. Blowing through.
Unit ready. Unit in production.
Ah, I see. So it's a gunship. Okay. Handy. So if you want to take out individual units, that's probably a better bet. If you want to blow stuff up, well, the bombers are much better.
Ready to engage.
I do love this teleport functionality. I assume there's a hotkey for it. I just don't know what that is yet. But being able to teleport your turrets towards the front line and gradually expand your base out with power conduits is pretty cool. You do have to watch out, though, because if you break those power conduits, then you're in a lot of trouble.
Ready.
as you might imagine, it doesn't work out too well for you. You end up losing power. Although it is possible for you to get an upgrade, which will make sure your turrets stay online regardless of that.
Unit in production.
Information. The harvest is plentiful.
Well, you are very, very dead by the looks of it.
Gladius ready.
Coordinating the tanks up to the front there. Alright, what can we build here? Did we get the stealth attachment? We did. Let's get the catalyst mine upgrade.
Beginning stealth tech upgrade.
Artillery upgrades. Howitzer mines. Longbows can target enemies on the ground. Artillery sentinels remain active without power connection. I like the proximity mine radar. That works. Let's build a stealth scout.
Unit ready.
And a bunch of howitzers and unit siege damage over time. This looks like a kind of ground void ray, from what I can tell.
Unit in production.
Location acquired. Assist. Cap there. Taking point.
Alright, let's send the gladiuses in and see what we can find.
Providing support. Heading there now. Coming there now. We control the air. On alert. Assemble. Support.
Yeah, we're going to have to take them out here, I think.
Coordinating movement. Right away. Location acquired.
I don't really feel like playing with Jesse at the moment. Thank you very much. I'm not sure what he's doing right now, actually. Is he playing Heroes again?
Eliminated.
I've just been getting very salty about that lately.
Tank operation. Formation moving. Assist heading there now.
There we go.
Next target.
The ultimate unit takes 9,000 resources. It's ridiculous. Very expensive. But yeah, I mean, that's basically Grey Goo. You have, at least in the case of two of the three factions, these four major upgrades, modular buildings, which will allow you to construct a variety of different stuff. The more advanced stuff requires multiple modules to be attached.
Howitzer here.
Let's get the howitzers in there. And then after that,
unit in production.
You are looking to maybe build an ultimate unit, and you've got these five upgrades that you can put in place. And once the upgrades are in, you're locked into those upgrades. So you've got to make a pretty big choice, let's just say. Voice acting's fine. I don't have any problems with it. I mean, that's one of the least important things that I could possibly think of when it comes to an
unit
RTS.
Ready.
But yeah, I mean, voice acting's fine.
Unit in production.
I want to see what these things do before we blow up everything.
Conform.
Apparently it has some kind of laser
support.
Thing.
Artillery
I want to
advance.
See what's going on with that.
Artillery support. Sharing telemetry.
But yeah, the faction that we're being up here is the beta faction, who I've played probably more of than the others. They mostly just use the modular construction. They can build pretty much anywhere. They don't need those big power things. So they're a little easier to control.
Location. On the way. Conform. Coming to
unit ready.
Okay, those are the howitzers.
Unit in
so
production.
They're pretty good.
Stealth tech upgrade complete.
Oh, those I assume are the lancers. Yes.
Unit
I can actually have
production.
Them fire on my own thing, I think.
Artillery tech upgrade.
Nope, apparently
complete.
Not. Damn, I want to see those things blow some stuff up before I completely destroy them, but I guess that's about it. Yeah, you know, it's so far, it's a solid RTS. Like it has some good systems behind it. I am maybe a bit worried about lack of depth. Because obviously there's not a lot of micro that you can really do. So it's very much kind of a macro game and getting the right force composition. But it works well. You know, it's not a bad game by any stretch of the imagination. It runs well, which is nice. Unit variety is decent enough. I think there's maybe a little bit too much crossover between the beta and the human units. They have units which perform very similar roles. The upgrades do diversify them a little bit, but like if you compare it to something like Zerg, Protoss, and Terran, of course, it's the asymmetry is not as strong. All right, we'll do one more game, which I'll play the final race, and I'll show you how they work. I'll try and build their ultimate unit because that's a lot of fun. All right. Go with Mountain Pass Twilight. There are three factions: Beta, Goo, and Human. we'll go up against the goo on this one. Game has a full campaign, which actually has some really nice cutscenes in it, like very high quality. They're actually so close, I can't even tell if they're green screen or computer rendered. They're that good. When you're in the first couple of missions, you see that you start as the Beta faction, and they look like people in really good makeup on a green screen. And I can't be 100% sure. They might be CG. It's like, that's an uncanny valley kind of thing going on there. Alright, cool. It's rock and roll. So, if you didn't like the overcomplicated UI, then you'll probably like the beta, because they don't have overcomplicated UI at all. They are probably the most simplistic of the three UIs. So, but you start in exactly the same way. You start from your headquarters here, but what you do here is you build hubs. These hubs can have either, I think, 2, 4, or 6 things attached to them at any given time. So we've got the refinery there built up nice and easy, no problems whatsoever. We can whack a silo on this side here, and then we can build a factory here. And then after that, once you've got a factory up, you're going to unlock a small hub, and then there's a medium hub, and then there's a large hub. These can be built pretty much anywhere within your line of sight, and you can build a mini base off these hubs. But of course, destroying the hub disables everything that's on it. Guns ready. Commando is your basic unit, is this guy. The beta have 4 arms, by the way, just for the hell of it. So this is kind of your basic scout unit. He's pretty effective, though. They can build walls, and those walls can become towers, and units can jump on top of them to fight, which is pretty cool. Not exactly. I don't know who wins in a commando versus a drover. I guess a commando wins, which is good. Hopefully kill that off. All right, so now I can build Stalker or a commando. Or I can add something to it, which I'd probably want to do. I could add hangers. I can add all of these add-ons here. So if we want to go, we go straight to stealth, and then we could actually unlock a stealth upgrade for the Stalker, which allows it to stay invisible and upgrades it with a sniper gun, which would make it very powerful early game, I think. You can tech rush in this game. I'm just not sure how effective it is, because it's obviously very costly, and it takes about 3 or 4 minutes to build a piece of tech. All right, cool. So we've got that. Let's turn resource display on so we can see where our expansion's going to be. If I recall correctly, you can actually mine resources from these areas here as well. Yeah, because this part of the river here, so we could actually expand quite close here. We get to put down a small hub. Beginning construction. There we go. So now we have a stealth attachment here. So if I get a stealth sniper upgrade, all of the stalkers that I build are going to start in stealth, and they're going to be upgraded with a long-range sniper rifle, which is going to be a bit of a problem because I imagine they don't have stealth tech early in the game. The goo is not modular. The goo is very different, as you'll be able to catch on the VOD. And of course, if you're just tuning in and you don't have subscription, then don't worry. I've given permission to people to re-upload my stream VODs, so there'll be a VOD that you can watch somewhere. All right, do I go straight for that? I think we're actually going to rush straight for the stealth sniper upgrade. I'm going to just rush for it right away and see if we can be an annoying little son of a bitch with stalkers. There we go. Right. On the move. Check. Also, the beta are South African, from what I can tell. Move out. We'll assist. Direction orders. Got you covered. Which is interesting. Okay, let's see if we can get another refinery up. Beginning construction. I think we can mine from there. We're just actually going to need visibility on it. It's a bit annoyingly fiddly. Like, I don't think you should really need visibility if you're that close. Either that, or they need to just increase the amount of... Oh, hello. That's not a pleasant-looking beast. Do you want to kill the Strider? I just need a target. Kill it. There you go. Nice. All units, this way. Confirming assist for the keep group. Move out. Check new direction orders. Refinery. All right. Complete. What are we looking at in the upgrades? 2 minutes left on the stealth upgrade. Refinery's finished. That's good. Let's just loop stalkers from one factory for the time being, and then try and do some stealth shenanigans. Need to find out where exactly their base is. It is the goo, so they could be anywhere. Yeah, we're going to try this stealth rush, basically, and see if that does the job. And if the goo doesn't build... I think the goo probably will react best to this, because they'll be able to build the, I think the Radiance, give them stealth detection. But we'll see. It might be an effective strategy. Okay, we've got things building at a decent rate. Let's get a medium hub out, and let's start building a little bit more. I think there's probably another expansion that I can take here.
Stalker, ready.
Alright. 1:25 on the research. Oh, hello, what do we find here? Things which are unpleasant.
Stalker awaiting.
I might have the firepower to kill at least one of these. Cool. We can actually maybe kill one of their goos, which would be pretty devastating. Oh, hello, okay. We got problems. But honestly, those units are not very good against stalkers, so I think we actually should be fine by the looks of it. Just micro that back. There we go. Cool. Let's go chase that thing down. It's hard to catch them because they can go up hills, which is not something that like a regular unit can do. So finding the goo when it runs off is difficult. Hello. We just want to make sure we don't get eaten by it. Tech upgrade is about done. 40 seconds. And we're looking good. Get back here. And we're looking good on the hub here as well. So let's get a large factory out. And we can get artillery upgrades for that. Oh, shit! You see, this is what happens when you don't pay attention.
Stalker, check. New direction orders.
All right, we should have stealth in a minute, though. And then we can start really pumping out stealth stalkers and try and hit them with those.
Unit ready.
I think on this hub, we might want to... Actually, let's just get a small hub over here. And we can just put an expansion on that instead. There, good. Walls, as I said, are just are towers, basically. The way that you defend as the beta is you put... There are some units which can climb on towers, and they just act as turrets. Okay, cool. We have artillery. Let's whack tank attachment on there as well. Hello. I'd rather you didn't, if at all possible. All right, stalkers have now stealth upgrade and sniper cannon, which is going to give them a huge range advantage. And they all spawn in stealth, which is sick. Okay, cool.
Small hub complete.
Might want to get a stealth scout unit of my own, actually.
Large factory complete.
Okay, large factory is done. That's good. And we can get some hailstorm artillery. Let's see about artillery tech upgrades. Anything good? So, hailstorms can gain the ability to move and fire. Guardian's ground weapon becomes a long-range artillery shot, and cloudburst can now target ground enemies. So, since we're currently building that, we'll get a platform stability upgrade. So we can move and fire. Let's get another one of these. There we go. All right, cool. We have our... We have our stealth upgrades now. Yeah, resource flow is just like Total Annihilation. So we might be able to use these to snipe off some of their mother goos before they can respond. So we can move around and hopefully be out of sight here. That's the plan anyway. Okay, we're completely out of cash right now, but that's something that should hopefully be fixable momentarily since we're about to take a third extractor.
Refinery.
In the meantime as well, might want to continue to build stalkers.
Unit introduction.
All units.
Macro is so much simpler in this game than it is in StarCraft. So if you had a problem with macro in StarCraft, well, this game does macro in a very easy way. Automatically distributes between factories. Everything's done through a nice set of key combinations. It's pretty cool.
Unit ready.
Units are definitely slow. It's not a fast-moving game. Definitely not StarCraft speed.
I'll be all units this way for the keep.
But yeah, I really want to find this goo and see if we can snipe
assist
it off.
New direction orders right behind
unit
you.
Ready. Unit in
hello, we found one. Let's see if we can kill it.
Let's run them down.
The AI is immediately going to try and run up the hill, and unfortunately, like, we will lose track of it. But I have stealth, so... Oh, they have stealth detection. Okay, let's blow it up before we end up losing. There we go.
New direction orders.
Ah, you're not getting away. Fuck no. Alright, we're going to have to micro against it by the looks of it. Oh, maybe not. It's running away. Couple more shots. Come on, we can get that goo. Get it. Get the goo. Sweet.
Unit introduction.
Oh, they're attacking my ship. Alright.
Attachment under attack.
Well, we have some large units that will probably do the job here, I think. Oh, fuck. They ate my entire army. Again, this is the one thing you got to watch out for against the goo. If you don't pay attention... The goo can just eat your whole army straight away. Immediately. Yes. Devastating.
Let's coordinate on this one. Going now.
Alright, let's get some more stalkers
unit
out.
Ready. Unit in production. Refinery under attack. Unit under
oh,
attack.
Fuck my life.
Harvester under
this is not good.
Refinery under attack.
I think we'll get, upgrades to try and help out with that.
Refinery under attack.
The goo is pissed.
Harvester under attack.
Hailstorm ready. Stalker moving.
Unit ready. Unit in production. Extractor under attack.
Clean kill. Artillery unit ready. On my location.
Alright, that's a bit better. Avalanche siege unit. Guardian can fire at... must be mounted to attack. So that's basically a turret. Okay, I see. I want to build the Hand of Rook. It requires 6,000 resources. And we're going to build the motherfucker.
Unit ready.
No
unit
doubt.
In production.
We need a factory that has all the upgrades. We need stealth tech and air tech on this thing. So let's see if we can do that. That means we'll need a large hub with six ports in order to make that happen. Which I will try and do. There we go. We'll start building it here.
All units, check.
Alright, let's send our stalkers out again and see if we can find another goo to kill. Yeah. I have this stealth unit to look around and see if I can find them.
Stalker.
The artillery should probably be enough to defend the base for the time being. So there's units coming from there, which means there should be a goo around here somewhere. So we should be able to go and assassinate it. Hopefully without getting horribly murdered in the process. In the meantime, walls would not be the worst idea I've ever come up with.
Beginning construction.
Stalker awaiting instruct.
Hello, looks like we have goo right there. Let's micro make sure we don't get eaten. I'm going to sack units to kill this goo. Absolutely.
Group.
Okay, it's dead. Good.
Confirming assistance.
Unit under attack.
New direction orders.
How long did Ted go back to stealth? Not long. So you can actually do some stealth micro with these units.
Large hub complete.
Cool. That's our hub done. So now what we do is we build a large factory on one side, and then we build all four tech attachments. One, two, three, and four.
Unit under attack. Beginning construction.
You can also make a gate. If you want, so
Stalker,
stuff will just go through there.
Target.
There we go. Alright, so we're saving money now. I don't think we have enough silos to even make this work, actually. We're not going to be able to hold up enough. We're going to have to build some more silo tech.
Beginning construction. Unit ready. Beginning construction.
Ah, fuck me.
Unit
leave it alone! What did it ever do to you?
Tank attachment complete. Artillery attachment.
You
complete.
Bastards. Get off.
Air attachment. Complete. Large factory under attack.
All right. How many more stalkers do we have?
Economic
enough to make this an all assassination
complete.
Force? Yeah, we've got a
large factory.
We found one of them over
attack.
There, so I'll go hunt him down.
Harvester under attack.
All right. So the grand plan,
factory,
assuming
complete.
We can actually manage to pull
unit
it off,
ready.
Is to build
unit
the Hand of Rook. Oh, you need two large
pilot.
Factories to do it? Holy crap! Okay.
Headquarters under attack.
Oh, that is not the upgrade I meant.
Upgrade.
No, I didn't mean to do that. So we need one more large factory. I can't fit that on there, though. Oh, God. So you've got to have one on either end, I guess? Yeah, that must be the way that it's done. So you've got to actually build it in a very specific alignment. Okay. So you build the large factory on the other end, and then you build the air attachment here? Okay, so that's what you need in order to build the ultimate unit.
Group maneuver. Check. For the keep. Group. Move out.
Yeah, it's supposed to be a full game on the 23rd. It's not early access or anything. This is this is, according to my Steam, this is gold now. So this is ready. I've not noticed any obvious bugs. Maybe a little bit of dodgy pathfinding from time to time, but that's about it. I don't want to be anywhere near that shit. I'm leaving. We killed another goo, and we're going to move back now. Because those things are nasty. All right, cool. So with this large factory, we should now be able to try and build the ultimate unit. Which is the Hand of Rook mobile battle platform. Which, if I recall, yeah, required structures must be attacked with the same power hub and are lost in the construction of the unit. So in other words, once everything's built, you actually convert this whole thing into a giant moving factory.
Large factory complete.
Upgrade to epic unit. All right. Well, I'm mining from three or four different places. I guess we'll see if that's enough. It's going to take a while, I think, to get that money together. All right.
Unit under attack.
Well, they're getting a little bit aggressive. Let's put the artillery behind the walls. And if they want to try and do here, we can set up set up the stalkers to assassinate them as they come in. Yeah, it has a full single player campaign. Voice acted, cutscenes, everything.
Unit ready. Unit in production.
We're actually producing at a high enough rate to build this thing, so... I'm a bit concerned about just protecting it to make sure it doesn't get blown up, so I'm going to send a contingent of stalkers over there.
Let's flatten something.
Units have a tendency of getting stuck on other units, which kind of annoys me a little bit. It makes the micro potential of the game a lot more awkward. So, like, in something like StarCraft 2, units will maneuver around each other quite nicely to allow precise micro. They do not in Grey Goo. So that's something to bear in mind.
Unit introduction.
I'm here. New direction orders.
Yeah, you're not going anywhere, Sonny. Quit eating my shit! There you go.
Confirming a
critical.
Yes. Stalker. Ready.
Yeah, the stealth stalker build seems to be pretty good. Seems to work quite well. You can just run around with a bunch of stalkers trying
stalker
to snipe off buildings.
Instruct.
Unit ready. Unit in production.
Yes, I definitely want to see what's going to come out of this thing. I believe we need some stuff to mount on it as well. What can actually mount up? Guardians can mount up. What else can... predators can mount up. So we can build a bunch of predators. We can also get the tank upgrade for predators, maybe. Yeah, predator volley, reduced to single fire shots. It's a good upgrade. There we go.
Unit ready.
Alright, 3 minutes until we get this thing. Assuming that I can afford it. I'm now building probably too much shit to actually afford it, but...
Stalker.
It'll finish eventually.
Stalker, you have a target.
Okay, let's grab this little stalker force and let's see if we can go hunt down some more goo. Because if he's doing something crazy like building a purger, I want to kill that before it gets up. Game runs well. I've had no frame rate problems of any description. I'm running at an absolute maximum. No problems at all. Seems well optimized from what I can tell, but obviously that's just on my system. Hello! Yeah, we're not going to let you do any of that, thank you very much. Oh, fuck, artillery coming our way. Alright, let's micro out of the way of it. Nope! Fuck you! You're not eating my army again. Did we get it? Oh, fuck, the bastard got away. Oh, man. We can kill that, though. Don't get hit by the artillery. Alright, he went that way. I'm gonna get him, whether he likes it or not. 2 minutes left on that. Okay, cool.
Predator reporting.
Now, predators, alongside some of the other units, this is what they can do. If you move up to a wall, they'll jump onto the wall. Like that, and they become a turret, basically.
Unit under attack.
And there's actually the unit, the Guardian unit, is designed to be used that way. And you can put commandos on there, you can put pretty much whatever unit you want on there. Oh, not all of them. There's like some stalkers can't go on there. There's some units that work just fine, there's some that don't. I'm gonna lose my stalkers, aren't I?
Yeah, probably.
Unless, actually, do they have stealth detection? Because if they don't, we can get away. Okay.
Extractor under attack.
What? We're being attacked. Fuck these guys. We need that money. We won't be able to finish the damn factory without it.
Tell me where to aim.
Unit ready. Unit in production.
Group maneuver. Check. Predators
there we go.
Extractor.
Right. They didn't quite blow up. That's always good.
Unit under attack.
Fix that up.
Repair.
Okay, what are we looking like money-wise? We can probably... Yeah, I don't think we're building any more of those. Nope.
Need to withdraw! Trying to hold it together!
We'll lose a few units defending it, but it's not a big deal. Alright, 40 seconds left on the Hand of Rourke. Which is the big, scary super unit, and then we can go murder people with it. And then I'll wrap the stream up after that, I think.
Group instruct. Check. Check.
Oh, what's that? Oh, it's a mini goo. Let's try and blow it up. What the fuck am I being hit by? Stealth or something.
Unit under attack.
I'm here. Yes.
You can micro against these guys, because they have more limited range weapons than the stalkers do. So you can stutter step. The turn speed is not that slow, so your stutter step is fairly effective. Alright, 10 seconds before we get the Hand of Rourke and see what this thing does. I've actually never seen this thing in action, so I'm going to have a bit of fun with it. That's my plan, anyway. Alright, this is the Hand of Rourke. It is a giant mobile factory. That's my understanding of it, at any rate. And apparently you can also mount units to it.
I'm almost offline.
So I'm mounting six predators to it.
And a brook, check.
And now we're gonna go have a bit of fun with it. Let's find out what the fuck is going on over here. It can also build units in the meantime, so if I want to build some avalanches, I can do that.
And redeploying. Moving.
Forward. Yes.
Ready to deploy. As one.
Where? Suddenly the goo is nowhere in sight. Can't say I'm hugely surprised. What the fuck was that? Please don't... Was that the...
Unit ready.
That looked worryingly like a purger. No way.
Awaiting instruct.
Unit under attack.
All right, we found a unit to blow up.
Unit under attack.
Holy shit! Whoa, okay, that is fun. All right, that is a big fucking gun. And it's got six turrets mounted to it now, and you can customize what you want on it by putting whatever units you want in the turret spots.
Under attack. Unit ready.
Hands unite.
Oh, that's brutal. It's a nuke cannon. I like that. That's pretty fun. And in the meantime, it's also building shit. You're not getting away. So now it's actually managed to drop down two siege units, which it's currently building while flying through the sky, which is a useful little piece of functionality, I would say. Yeah. Hand of Ruck gives no fuck.
Location check. Deploying.
Unit under attack. Extractor under attack.
Push.
All right. Well, that, as they say, I think is that. That demonstrates kind of all the three factions of this game and the kind of gameplay you can expect from it. I believe it's out on the 23rd, if I recall correctly. It does have a full campaign skirmish mode, 1v1 and 2v2 supported, and I believe it has a map editor as well. That's my understanding. It's alright. It's a good solid RTS, which frankly we don't have all that many of. Like, if you're looking for like super high micro potential esports stuff, then this is not it. There's no doubt about that. But if you're looking for something which is a more of a straight-up real-time strategy you can play with your friends and you want a campaign mode, then this game's got that. It actually plays pretty well for the most part. So it is not a bad RTS at all. It's actually pretty good. But just bear in mind, of course, I'm a StarCraft 2 esports team owner, so my expectations are going to be a little bit different to other people's minds. Let's get the siege units up there. We should do the trick. Yes. Goodbye, Mrs. Goo.
Hand of Rook under
lovely.
Attack.
We do like the Hand of Rook, absolutely.
Unit
that is quite the fun action.
Unit. Unit under attack.
Alright, cool. That pretty much wraps it up. I'll give you a quick look at the options menu before you leave, as you asked for. So you got Gamma, you got your full screen windowed, which is always nice to have. Pretty much every video resolution you can ask for is all here. I can go up to 4K if I want to. Advanced video looks something like that. Everything's kind of up there. Gameplay options. This is kind of what's lacking a little bit. As I say, UI scaling I would like to see changed around a bit. You can rebind all the hotkeys in the game. As you can see here, you can even change the way that the quick interface is actually grouped, which is pretty good. So you've got a lot going on with that. A lot of stuff. All of that is fully rebindable. You can set camera locations, you can do offensive and defensive pings, which is quite handy. The good old shift select functionality works. Your standard control 1 through 9 also works for grouping, so that's all good. You can hold ground, you can attack move, all of the stuff that you kind of expect from an RDS is there. And you actually have a kind of shocking amount of audio options. Quite a lot. Quite a lot. Yeah, so that's Grey Goo. That's what it's going to look like. And hopefully that was at least in some way useful to you. The WTF is scheduled to be out on the 23rd, because that's when the embargo lifts. But hopefully that's given you a little bit of information on the game regardless. And I'm pretty much going to wrap things up now, I think. Thank you very much for watching. Very much appreciated. I am told that some of the other Polaris folks are currently streaming. So you might want to actually have a look and see what they're up to. I have no idea what they're up to right now. Not a bloody clue. What is Jesse doing? Probably wasting everybody's time, I would imagine. Still uses Shibuzi, doesn't he? Oh, he's playing Heroes of the Storm. Okay, right, that makes sense. I could detect the salt from here. Twitch, I don't know what Dodge is doing at the moment, though. But feel free to go watch either of those. Thanks a lot for watching, folks. Hopefully you had fun, and I will see you next time.